Hey, boys. Hey, girl. We're going to make us some hamburgers and poutine, which is basically French fries with cheese with hot gravy poured on top of them. You know, down here in the South, we also have what's known as a French fry po' boy, which is about the same thing, except it's on po' boy bread. But poutine, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. A good friend of mine, Booger, hey Booger, sent this to me. And first thing I got to do is filter my oil. So I got this little filter cone holder. This was 10 bucks. 50 filter cones was 10 bucks. So you open this cone up, and the instructions say, look here, they come with instructions. It say right there to filter the oil hot, not cold. So I'm warming up my oil. I need to filter it from my deep fryer. Here we go from here. I wonder how deep fried hamburgers would taste. Oh well. I already deep fried T-bones a while back, and they come out good. It sealed the moisture inside. They were fantastic. Deep fried pork chops. Kind of like deep fried fried fish. Flesh. Burp. Three Stooges quote. All right. It's raining like a fool. I'm a barbecue anyway. Not barbecue. I'm gonna grill some damn burgers any damn way. So we got all that's hot. I keep my oil in the ice box, the refrigerator, and it keeps longer. It don't go rancid as quick, depending on what you fry in it. So, dumping the oil into the filter. Seeing the filter do its job. See this way? See the junk? It done filtered out. The oil not as pretty is when it come. The oil ain't as pretty as when it come fresh out the bottle. But it ain't burned yet. You continue cooking with this crap and you're gonna burn your oil. Kind of like old burn motor oil. It'll burn up your motor and your boat. Okay, so we got that dead. Now you throw this away. $10 for 50. Do the math. I'm gonna drink a beer. And worry about that another time. So wipe out any excess little pieces that may have gotten left over when you poured your oil out. And then pour your oil back in. And we gotta add a little bit more oil because we lost some. Through the filter and from the last cook. See, you got a line up in that. You can snort that. Go stick your straw in there right now and snort that. See what happens. You'd be some pissed off. So adding the oil and getting it back up to the line. And no, don't snort that, boy. I was making it funny. I say, boy. Look at here when I'm talking to you. So we go get this warmed up and I gotta make some burger patties. Oh, yeah. Now, I've had this asked before. How many times can you reuse your oil? Depends on what you did with it, what kind of oil it is, and how you stored it. Did you burn it? Did it have dead fish in it? Does it stink? Throw it away. Can't use it no more. Different oils have different smoking temperatures, etc., etc., etc. There's an old wise tale that says if your oil tastes bad or smells bad, you can put potatoes in it, like fresh cut potatoes, and fry them in there, and it's going to remove the smell and the bad taste. The oil's rancid, throw it away. You're going to ruin your dish. I don't believe all them wise tales or wives' tales. So, yeah, you just got to watch. Oh, I know. I was going to say, if you're cooking something that's got a lot of breading on it, breading like flour that's going to fall off in the bottom of the oil, that can burn it. Or the little particles that fell off the food can burn and ruin the oil. So like if you're making a lot of fried chicken, and you're making batches and batches, you may have to filter the oil in between batches, and you may end up, let's say you're making 50 pounds of fried chicken. You better get a commercial deep fryer, number one, or just replace the oil in the middle of the cook. Different types of fryers work better. Sure, most people may want to just use a cast iron skillet and frying using a meat thermometer. That works just fine. Not a meat thermometer, one of them candy looking thermometer things that you clip on the side of the pot. You can do that. Fry daddies and other types of fryers that have immersion elements work better. If you're going to do a lot of frying, you may want to invest in one. Okay, now you know. How about that? Oh, you can get what boogers got. Or you can get what boogers got. She's got a T-fowl. How you call it? A T-fowl. It fries with no oil. She used it in a couple videos. I forget what it's called. A T-fowl. How you call it? That's what it is. Non-union ass camera. What I like to do for my burgers is use 80-20 ground chuck, which is what I have right over here. And if you don't like buying ground meat, then grind it yourself. And I put some salt and pepper down right here, and I'm gonna form a couple patties on it. And Miss JB's not eating because she's on some medication. It's got her speeding her ass off. Oh well, she needs it. I don't need it. I'm drinking pop. Soda pop, right? Right, good. Let me form a couple patties and we'll salt the top side. Pepper this up the stop sign too. So I'm gonna go ahead and grill these with some wood on my grill. And we'll save this for another day. Maybe I'll make one more. I may be hungry later on. Now it looks like the lens is fogged up on the camera because it's raining. There's you some flame ball brawl burgers over mesquite wood. Never ever mash down on them. You squeeze the juice out. Don't do it. You do, you're gonna stay stupid the rest of your life and be totally non-union. Flip them often if you want, but don't mash. This ain't mash. You want to watch that? Go watch mash. Okay, let's go ahead and make this this brown gravy is what it is. Poutine gravy. Had it before. It's really good. It's just a brown gravy mix. You can make it yourself. We need to put some cold water in here first. I think it calls for like 2.5 cups of cold water. So we're gonna do that. And we're gonna whisk in the gravy mix. Come on. Y'all all come out of there. It's a gravy mix. If you can't get this, get McCormick. If you can't get McCormick, shit. Make it your damn self. It's really like a roux that's got some seasonings in it. Salts and peppers and stuff like that. So whisk this together. And you gotta heat it up and it's gonna thicken up. Big time, and you gotta stir it constantly while it's heating up. Naturally, it's not gonna heat up on a countertop, huh? Now the main thing for your gravy is it's gotta be smoking hot. And when you pour it on top of the hot French fries fresh out to Earl, you want this to melt the cheese and just get all yummy and happy. It's not quite ready yet. See, it's still a little too thin. It's gotta come up and it's gonna get thicker. That's what we're looking for. Okay, so I chop up some lettuce. Well, I want a salad. I really don't care about rabbit food on my burger. We may put a little sprinkling on it, but it's my centrifuge. See, it's slinging out all the water that I washed. I washed the lettuce, put it in here, and let it dry. The breaks pop up. Now, and ready for salad. The gravy ready. All we gotta do is keep it warm. See it done ticking up big time. That's what you want to see. We got to make some french fries. Oh shit, yeah. Burgers are done. They in the oven keeping warm. Get the Earl hot, make some Frenchy fries. And I got some frozen fresh from the damn stove. I don't know if you fellas know, guys, girls, but these have already been pre-cooked once and then flash frozen. And then when you cook them again, that's a second cook. And this is what McDonald's does to their fries. They're done in a similar fashion. Now you know. So let's make us some poutine. Got some hot fries. And you bust up some cheese curds, which I don't have. All I got is some mozzarella cheese. String cheese, as it's called. Then you take some of that hot gravy. Ooh, that's a hot gravy. And pour it right on top. See, like that? Canadian poutine. Eh? Miss JB never had that.
Ah, looks good.
See right there? Right there. Yum. We'd put this on a po' boy and eat that. Booger, this is real good, man. With that string cheese in there. And then fried. Fried potatoes and gravy. Can't go wrong with that, with cheese. Yum. Shit, I'm inhaling this. Yum. Let me give me another bowl. What a burger. The hell with the burger. We'll feed them to the dogs. So here's what you do. Get you some mayonnaise, mustard, pickles, rabbit food. Put it right on top of your burger. There's your pickle. I don't have any maters. I don't have any Phil's Dills ready. I got some marinating. Getting ready. And soon he's going to have them ready to sell to you fine people. See right down there? Yum. A burger. See in there? Burger, burger. Cheeseburger, cheeseburger. You want cheese? Put cheeseburger.